I think one of the big opportunities with the simulator environment is comfort knowing what to do in an emergency. The numerous events that you can program in and you can execute with an operator and watch how they react. It gives you, not only you as the miner, confidence that your operators are going to react the appropriate way. The operators have confidence, they know where the critical safety features of that machine are, and it's muscle memory. When they need to hit an emergency stop, they know. It's inherent to their core being. Even when you just look at outside of the safety element, the reliability of the machine, there's the ability to simulate things like boom jacking. Boom jacking is typically one of the worst things you can do on a rope shovel. The ability of the simulator environment allows you to put the machine into that situation in a controlled space that the operator knows how to react without risking a valuable asset on your property. We look at examples like our TRC dipper on the P&H shovels. Having the ability to simulate that dipper can speed up successful deployment of that dipper across a mine site. One of the big things with the adoption of the TRC dipper is the change in site picture, as we call it. The dipper, the handle, they're at different angles than operators are accustomed to with the technologies that had been in the industry for the past 20 some years. Having the simulator environment starts to prepare operators for something that's gonna look and feel different initially, that when they're in the real world, they know what right looks like. We talk about filling the dipper. I can't see into the dipper sitting in the operator's cab on the shovel, but the auxiliary views in the simulator environment allow me to start to see for a given position of that dipper and handle, how full is my dipper? Am I positioning myself correctly? So it's just building my confidence that I could operate the machine in an effective manner. This was my first chance to play with the Pro 5 simulator. My previous experience was the LX6. And what was unique with this one is having that stereoscopic and kind of that true 3D immersion. You're able to put your head in the positions, you're forced to turn and look and reposition the way you would be really on the machine to see some of those key elements of operating the machine. That not only do you have the noises, you have the haptic feedback coming through the seat, but as I'm looking around, as I'm trying to judge where the next dig is, where that truck's gonna be, the environment is reacting the way it would in the real world if I were on a machine. There are areas on the machine that you actually do need to contort your body. You do need to look lean. Again, it's building that muscle memory that if I want to see my tracks, for example, I do need to lean forward and look down. And the sim environment does give you that ability to get that muscle memory of looking forward and down for tracks. Yeah, it was really surprising just spending as much time on shovels throughout my career as I have, that getting in the simulator here today, it felt like I was riding along. As I looked around with the head tracking, it replicated what I would expect a modern simulator to do. The view you get with the simulator and the head track and the stereoscopic, it does build such a real environment that you get used to having to operate the machine the way you really would in the real world. So you're looking for the right cues. You're building this sense of repeatability and muscle memory that when you jump on the machine in real life, you're gonna feel comfortable. It's gonna feel second nature. It's not gonna feel foreign.